Why are there so many copies of the Visual C++ runtime? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. This is a very common question. Do I really need all the Microsoft Visual C++ redistributable downloads? Can I delete some? I'm sorry to say, you probably do need them, and no, you should not delete any of them. I have 6 copies myself. This is a symptom faced by software vendors that, at its core, is unsolvable in any pragmatic sense. The problem even has a name, DLL hell, although it has migrated in scope since that term was invented. The origin of the problem is very simple. Programmers not trying to duplicate work that's already been done. For example, let's say I'm working on a program. I write a little bit of code that does something moderately useful. Perhaps it's a simple function to convert all alphabetic characters in a string to lowercase. It takes a string of characters like uppercase ask Leo and converts it to lowercase ask Leo. It's not uncommon for many programs to require that feature. So rather than writing or including a case conversion function into every program that might want it, we package it up into what's called a library. Any program that wants to convert a string of characters to lowercase simply uses the library function. The software developers don't have to write, test, or include their own version of that function. The Microsoft Visual C++ runtime is nothing more than a large collection of those kinds of functions. They're not nearly as simple as just changing the case of characters in a string, but they are things that are very common in programs written in Microsoft Visual C++, a programming language, specifically for Windows. By providing all this functionality in one package, programs are then easier and faster to write since they don't have to duplicate all this effort, and they end up being somewhat more stable because they also don't have to re-implement all that stuff and add their own flavor of bugs and testing all of that stuff. So far, that much, at least, is mostly true. But we need to talk about progress versus compatibility. As time goes on, several things can happen. Programs change and improve in response to customer and market demand. The software those programs are built on, like Microsoft Visual C++, also change and improve to provide the functionality required to make those customers and markets happy. Bugs, errors, are created and fixed. New versions are released. As I mentioned, I have 6 copies of the Visual C++ runtime on my machine. In an ideal world, a program relying on a single copy, say the 2010 X64 redistributable, would be equally served by the 2013 version of that redistributable. It's just a new version after all. We don't live in an ideal world. Depending on how it's written, a program written to use the 2010 version might experience failures if it tried to use the 2013 version as a replacement. That program requires the 2010 version, no matter how many subsequent versions are installed. Now, you might think, great, if you uninstall it, uninstall the program that needs it, can you make it go away? Again, it's not quite that simple. Consider this scenario. You install program A, and they use library version 2010. You then install program B, and it also uses library version 2010. So it doesn't need to install it. It can just use the copy that was already there, courtesy of program A. Now, you uninstall program A. 3 things can happen. It uninstalls the library because it installed it and it should clean up after itself, not realizing that another program relies on the library. As a result, program B breaks. It never uninstalls the library because another program might use it. As a result, libraries check in, but they never leave. Third, we devise some method of tracking how many installed programs are using the library and only remove it when the last one is uninstalled. Unfortunately, any single program's failure, be it a programming error or a failure to install or uninstall properly, breaks this technique. At best, you're left with copies of a library you no longer need. And at worst, uninstalling one program can cause one or more other programs to fail. It's a mess. In fact, it's such a mess, many programs now don't bother to try and share at all. One of the most entertaining scenarios of this problem is that of all the large application suites, it's not uncommon for two things to be true. Even if most of the suite is written for a 64-bit platform, there may still be 32-bit utilities, which run just fine on a 64-bit operating system. But that means that both the 64-bit and the 32-bit version of the runtime needs to be included. And even if most of the suite is written for version X of the runtime library, there may still be portions that rely on version Y or version Z. So both or all three must be included, again, possibly in both the 32 and 64-bit flavors. Now, I will readily admit it could have been better, but it's not. I'm sure that there are lots of ways that this problem could have been approached differently from the start. That this isn't as nearly a big a deal on non-Windows platforms is perhaps the single biggest sign of that. Those platforms either don't attempt this kind of code sharing, or they do it in less interdependent and fragile ways. And while developers can still benefit from not needing to reinvent the wheel each time they need it, they end up shipping and installing a lot of wheels with every program that need them. That saves some work by not starting from scratch each time, but your system becomes littered with different versions of essentially the same thing. So, bottom line, ultimately, we just don't know what's safe to delete. Thus, the safest approach, by far, is to leave well enough alone and delete nothing. For updates, for comments, for links to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/18102. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is AskLeo.com. Thanks for watching.